Hi everyone, today we are going to talk about something that has a very big impact on how we work together, how we communicate with each other and how we handle challenges. That is emotional intelligence.
Emotional intelligence is an infestation of mindset. Emotional intelligence refers to the ability how we handle our emotion and others' emotion. It plays a very crucial role for the personal and professional improvement, for better communication and many more things at workplace, and how we can handle our emotions.
Yeah, that's a very good answer, and this is why emotional intelligence is very important in our workplace, especially in our workplace, because we face so many problems like stress, time, deadlines and negativities in workplace. But the main thing is that how we can handle it and how we will overcome it. Emotional intelligence has so many benefits, like on team level, we can communicate with each other very efficiently, we can work with each other, we can understand each other, and in personal level, it is also helpful because by learning emotional intelligence, it will help in improving our leadership qualities, understanding others, and even it will be crucial in our career growth also.
So emotional intelligence is important at our workplace because when we are criticized by someone or our work, so we take it in a healthy way, but it is not good for our. We have to take it in healthy way and work on it, and so we can efficiently do our work and do it properly. If anybody is criticizing you, so don't take it in negative. It is all about your work, and it's important to know about emotional intelligence so we can handle our emotions and control how on the situation, on the different situations we are in workplace.
So it's an important quality of a leader also, because a leader with emotional intelligence does not focus on the work or the result. They will also focus on the emotions of the employer, like how my decision would affect the employer emotions. And the leaders with emotional intelligence also have a very good decision making, because they will see all the aspects that how my decision would affect my employees' emotion.
Right, so it's
one of the very important quality so every leader should have, because if you are having this quality, then you are taking leader kind of work, not as a just a name.
Yeah, right. So like for a leader, have must have quality. Leader have a good emotional intelligence, then he can cope up with the employees and create a harmonious environment for the employees. If employees have some problems and facing some issues, so we can collaborate with him, empathize him, and provide some emotional support.
Yes, like he said, emotional intelligence is very important for us, and especially in workplaces. And the employees are likely to follow a leader which is more emotional intelligence. Like if I am a leading manager of a team and you are my employees, I would like, if I see that you are working on a project and you are stressed out and feeling more anxious and feeling burnout, and I would go, if I am emotionally intelligent, I would go give a speech, motivational speech, because if my employees are motivated about their work, they would perform well, which as a result, the organization will get much rewards, and it also helps in emotional intelligence, very important for a teamwork, because teamwork is what all we work together and get our great results.
A leader should be an emotionally intelligent person so that he can handle other teammates emotionally and in their work and also at the emotional level.
Not only leaders, but the employee can also have to be that easy, because we have heard about that incident that has happened recently. In Kolkata, a female employer named Taruna Saxena, and that has been died by suicide. Whose company has worked continuously to her, and she is suffering from overload, and she is suffering from stress due to overload, and that then to manage that stress, she tried to go for suicide. So I think more and less. This cause due to less awareness about emotional intelligence.
emotional intelligence is, because if she has some important emotional intelligence, then this incident should not have been occurred.
Right. So like this depends on the company that we create and this is what my parents in the life of the employee. And these that it's not the that concern me to that we can commit suicide.
But everyone also should be aware about emotional intelligence so that they can handle themselves and others emotionally.
But apart from everyone, I think companies should also have to ensure that they are hiring the people who are counselors and have.
And in terms of cases, every company should offer a webinar and other counselors.
Now that's the problem that I have studied, that in a recent study, it is found that only 38% of people are emotionally intelligent and they are aware about this concept. That means most of the people are not even aware, they are not even literate about this thing. So awareness is a very important factor in this. And we in workplace, companies should attend some webinars and some counselors. They should have at least one counselor in every company for such situations, so employee can handle it privately too. Because sometimes it's not easily accessible and even all the employees, they don't want to share their emotions publicly. So dealing with it privately will be more convenient. And if anyone wants to add
yes, this is a very nice solution to have seminars and webinars on the topic of emotional intelligence. But I think that we can develop emotional intelligence on our personal level also, in the space of our team also. Like we should be empathetic towards our teammates. We should be understanding our teammates and how well they are doing, how their mental state is doing, whether they are stressed or not. So we should talk to them politely. We should avoid rudeness. Like we should cope up with them.
Exactly. Many of the person are facing challenges on implementing of emotional intelligence because they are not handling their emotions correctly. Also at workplace, but also privately.
Right. On a personal level, like
yeah, they can't be able to handle their emotions.
Right. So they suppress their emotions, and when they do it for the long time, it have very bad effect on the mental health and us. They also become very irritated, like they get irritated on the small things. Mm-hmm. Like this happens, like in their daily to daily life.
At workplaces,
there are many employees who are unable to express their ideas because they will think that how others will think about me. I will give this idea because they have a mindset like everyone will judge me. You should create a non-judgmental environment in a workplace.
There are various challenges
who
are people are facing about that. Just like one of them is environment. If a person is not having a good environment, then he can't able to express his emotion and also can't able to control his emotion.
As a solution to that, I think that we can create the emotionally intelligent environment in a workplace. The team should be emotionally intelligent. We can develop those things like having group activities so that we can know each other. We can know each other how the trigger points of someone else is, our teammates is. Like, we should know about them, how they can handle stress so that we can give them, we should avoid giving them stress accordingly, but as we all know that they are workload. So we can give them accordingly so that they can handle them and manage the workload.
Right.
And that a good leader that has well skill, well ability of emotion intelligence that can do, I think, well.
They have a second challenge to go to listen to others. And we see in today's generation, we are not listening to others. We are always trying to interrupt others or others who we usually do.
Yeah, they don't have patience.
That's how the front one who is expressing is feeling or feeling to me or to you.
Yes, and so we can develop emotional intelligence by being polite, by being calm. So we have to listen to the person that is saying something to us. We first understand them, and then we should put our point on the topic.
Another challenge we face by implementing the emotional intelligence at workplace is that time consistency. at the fast-paced environment, we want a fast success, but emotional intelligence is a slower time-taking process to having a good or a strong emotional intelligence at workplace.
If one, we can learn this part by practicing with experiences. We don't learn it from the book and we don't watch content on that. Either you suppress our emotions or you become over expressive like this.
Also, a leader or a boss should be emotionally intelligent so that he would not apply pressure on the employees to
do the work. Is putting in his life in only that rest. No one is putting time in meditation and all.
We can develop emotional intelligence on a personal level by doing yoga, by doing meditation, so that we can make our mind calm. It should be calm at stressful situations.
Yeah, I can help some people at expressing their emotions because many of the person are not able to express their personal emotion. Not
either in their workplace, but also at a personal level. Because
they don't have a close person so that they can express their feelings, how they are feeling.
Yeah, mostly people feel lonely. People don't understand their emotions and they will judge them. Like, we can see that it is a part of society, we can impact the society. And men usually don't express their emotions. They feel like if they express emotions, they try on their situation, society will judge them. Yes. Or our mothers can rise, so we can see that our mothers are more emotionally, like they
can show their emotions more freely.
We can take smaller step, like we can make small groups of this, where we can develop this skill. And there are many, there are many courses of this nowadays, but people are not aware of this. We should create an environment like there are several courses you can enroll in them, and there are many books. Even the title is like emotional intelligence. It is above the height. By the title you can judge it how important this skill is.
Yes.
That's a very important thing. You all have said, but well, it's not about expressing. What about acting? What about when we get affected by others' words and their actions?
Exactly. How the person control their emotions.
That is when we should learn self-regulation. We should know how to regulate our emotions. We should not impulsively react on anything. So that we should avoid taking wrong decisions. We should be calm in some situation. We should take a step back and think about what in situation we are in. So that we can analyze the situation and then take a decision. That would be very smart.
I totally agree with your point that sir, but sometimes it's not possible to react at that way because we are humans, we work on impulsive decisions. So how to develop such qualities in ourselves?
I think that we can create a positive, non-judgmental workplace environment so that everyone should be free to express their feelings and they should know that no one here is going to judge me.
We should help ourselves and be aware of how to control our emotion, and we should be emotionally intelligent so that we can personally handle ourselves emotion and also help others.
Yeah, I also think that we should take small steps each, and first we should start with little meditations and self-control, and even changing our perspective would also help. Because if we will start to see things from others' perspective, it would be a very big help in understanding emotional intelligence.
Yeah, I agree with you. Only you can start with a small step. Start like if we start taking small steps and try to educate others, like if we try to educate the kids, it's good. And in their subconscious mind, and when they grow up, they empathize with others and understand the emotions of others, right?
If we have emotional intelligence, it will affect our efficiency to do well in our workplaces, increase, and we do the proper way of the work.
Yes.
And
yes.
We can be more efficient and productive.
More ideas, will come from the employer without hesitation.
For an athlete, we have to focus on the 2 or 3 more abilities like self-awareness, self-management, and one is
empathy towards each other. We can work on we should be motivated towards the work
in social skills. Because we all know that it is not just a skill but a set of abilities. And for catching it, we have to.
Not only on social level, but on a personal level, it could help us for not even in workplace, in future, in our future life, it could be very beneficial. Because learning emotional intelligence would grow us in our career so much. It could help us because if you are in a situation, let's consider it, if you are giving a presentation, first one, if we are nervous and giving it with anxiety, and second one, we are giving confidently. What do you think? Which one is better? Obviously, the confident one. And that's when the emotional intelligence helps. If we are emotionally intelligent, and if you are understanding others, if you are confident, then you can speak freely and you can deliver your ideas more efficiently. And people will consider you and even appreciate you more, and it would eventually help you to grow further.
Yeah, so like one more point, we should be stay motivated, and this can be implemented. We should notice ourselves how we are feeling at present, how we are actually at present. I mean, at an emotional level. And day by day, we should improve ourselves so that in future we can compare ourselves and improve ourselves. So
yes, this skill will help you at every step of life, like not only in the workplace, so
but
stay
motivated in that situation.
Yes.
So can we conclude?
Yes, I think that we should conclude our group discussion here. So I will conclude this on a note that I think there might be a solution on developing EI, that is emotional intelligence. We can add it to curriculum of our students at a very small age, but not that small, like 14 years of age or 16 years of age, so that they must be intelligent enough to understand about emotional intelligence. They can develop emotional intelligence, and from that, if they begin, the world can be a very peaceful place to live.
Yeah, exactly. A healthy and a cooperative environment should be created so that everyone can express and everyone can be heard,
everyone can express, everyone should put themselves in other shoes. Like we have heard this idiom also, we should know that what the other side is thinking. We should understand
this should start from the family, and we should introduce the curriculum to the students.
Yes.
So we introduce coding in the coding for the kids. So we can also introduce subjects like that.
Yes.
To help them out in the workplace.
Only technical skill is not important for living a good life. These kind of skills, these skills are also very much important.
The impact in our life is very important.
It creates human values.
Exactly. This
helps
us a lot in our personal life. So emotional intelligence is very important.
And a very last point, that first of all, we should start working on ourselves, because change in us would change
a good thing in society.
A small step can lead us to a very big step in the society.
Thank you.